Friends, a very good morning to all of you. In this session, I'm going to discuss about the problems, how to solve the problems on the electric field intensity due to point charge distribution and also other types of charge distribution like continuous charge distributions or the line charge distribution, surface charge distribution. Let us see how to solve the problems on the electric field intensity due to point charge distribution. So before solving the problems, first I want to focus on the formulae which are important for solving the problems on the electric field intensity. The first one is the formula which shows the electric field intensity for the point charge distribution. So as you know, electric field intensity is a vector quantity. We can represent the electric field intensity vector form. So electric field intensity due to point charge distribution E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square into unit vector A R. Next is electric field intensity due to line charge distribution. So this is the infinite line charge distribution. Electric field intensity due to infinite line charge distribution E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into R, unit vector AR, volts per meter. Rho L is the line charge density. So for the line charge distribution, we have the charge density called line charge density, which is the ratio of charge divided by the length, or dQ divided by dL. Next formula is electric field intensity due to infinite surface charge distribution. Here magnitude is given. So if you want to write electric field intensity in the vector form, we can write vector E is equal to, so magnitude of the electric field intensity into direction of the unit vector or unit vector AR. So here magnitude of the electric field intensity due to surface charge distribution is given, that is E is equal to rho S divided by 2 epsilon naught, where rho S is the surface charge density. See, for the surface or the sheet charge distribution, we have the charge density called surface charge density, which is defined as the ratio of the elementary charge divided by elementary surface area, that is nothing but dQ divided by dS. The last one is the electric field intensity at a point on the axis of the charged circular ring, that is E is equal to rho L into R into Z divided by 2 epsilon naught into R square plus Z square volt to the power of 3 by 2. Let us see the first problem. Two charges QA is equal to 1 microcoulomb and QB is equal to 4 microcoulombs, which are separated by a distance of 4 centimeters, and the constant K is equal to 9 in 10 power 9 newtons meter square per coulomb square. What is the magnitude of the electric field at the center between the QA and the QB? So first let us write the constants given in the problem. So what are the constants given in the problem? Charge QA is given, or charge at the point A is given, that is QA is equal to 1 microcoulombs. So micro is nothing but 10 power minus 6, therefore 1 in 10 power minus 6 coulombs. Charge B, that is QB, is equal to 4 microcoulombs, 4 in 10 power minus 6 coulombs. And the constant K is equal to 9 in 10 power 9 newtons meter square per coulomb square. So you know K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and it is equivalent to 9 in 10 power 9 newton meter square per coulomb square. Distance between the charge A and charge B is also given, that is 0.04 the meters. Distance between the charge A and the center point is 0.02 meters, and distance between the charge B and the center point is 0.02 meters. So here in this problem, you are observing that, see, the two charges which are separated by a distance 4 centimeter, which is shown in the figure, and you are required to find the electric field intensity at a point which is the center. That point is center between the charge A and the charge B, and that the if you want to find the electric field intensity at the center point due to the charge 1 is nothing but E1 is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. So there the distance between the charge A and the center point is 2 cm, nothing but 0.02 meter. Suppose if you want to find electric field intensity at the center point due to charge B, means the distance between the charge B and the center point is 2 cm again, that is 0.02 meters. To find, so what you are required to find? You are required to find the magnitude of the electric field at the center between the charge A and the charge B. See, electric field produced by the charge A at the center point EA is equal to K into QA divided by RA square. You know the value of the constant K is equal to 9 in 10 power 9. QA is 1 microcoulombs. RA means, so the from the charge A to the center means it is half of the total distance, that is 4 cm. Half of the 4 cm means 2 cm, nothing but 0.02 meters. So therefore, in the formula, if you substitute, it becomes 0.02 square. Then it is it becomes equal to 9 in 10 power 3 divided by 0.0004 is nothing but 9 in 10 power 9 by 4 in 10 power minus 4. This is equivalent to 2.25 in 10 power 3. Newtons per coulombs. Newtons per coulombs. So this is 2.25 in 10 power 7 newtons per coulombs. This is the electric field intensity at the center between the charges A and B due to the charge A. Next, what is the electric field produced by the charge B at the center point? Electric field produced by the charge B at the center point EB is equal to K into QB divided by RB square. That is 9 into 10 power 9, 4 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 0.02 whole square. And this is equivalent to 9 into 10 power 7 newtons per coulombs. So what is the resultant electric field at the center point? Resultant electric field at the center point E is equal to EB minus EA. So what is EB? EB obtained here is 9 in 10 power 7 newtons per coulombs, and EA obtained here is 2.25 in 10 power 7 newtons per coulombs. If you subtract EA from EB, you will get 6.75 in 10 power 7 newtons per coulomb. So this is the net or the resultant electric field intensity or the strength of the electric field at the center of the two charges QA and the QB. Next problem, charge Q3, which is located at 5 cm rightward and rightward of the Q2, as shown in the figure below. What is the magnitude of the electric field at charge Q3? So that is Q3 is equal to 1 microcoulombs, that is 1 in 10 power minus 6 coulombs is equivalent to 10 power minus 6 coulombs. Let us write the constants given in the problem. Charge Q1 is given, that is 5 microcoulombs, that is 5 into 10 power minus 6 coulombs. And charge Q2 is also given, that is minus 5 into 10 power minus 6 coulombs. Distance between the charge Q1 and the charge Q3, that is 15 cm, nothing but 0.15 meters. And distance between the charge Q2 and charge Q3 is 5 cm, nothing but 0.05 meters. So that is nothing but 5 into 10 power minus 2 meters. And the constant K value, K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, that is equal to 9 in 10 power 9 newton meter square per coulomb square. So you are required to find charge Q, required to find the electric field at the charge Q3. To find the electric field at the charge Q3, we need to find the electric field at charge Q3 due to charge Q1. Electric field intensity at the point of charge Q3 due to charge Q1, that is E1 is equal to K into Q1 by R1 square. What is the distance between the charge Q1 and charge Q3? You know, 15 cm, right? That is a 15 in 10 power minus 2 meters. So E1 is equal to K means 9 in 10 power 9, and Q1 is 5 microcoulombs divided by R1 is 15 cm, that is 15 in 10 power minus 2 whole square. So simplifying this, you will get E1 is equal to 0.2 in 10 power 7 newtons per coulombs. Then what is the electric field at the charge Q3 due to the charge Q2? That is E2 is equal to K into Q2 divided by R2 square. Therefore, E2 is equal to 9 in 10 power 9 into 5 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 5 in 10 power minus 2 whole square. and this is simplified to E2 is equal to 1.8 in 10 power 7 newtons per meter. Now we are going to find resultant electric field at the charge Q3. Resultant electric field at the charge Q3, E is equal to, what is that, E2 minus E1. So what is E2? 1.8 in 10 power 7 newton per coulombs minus 0.2 in 10 power 7 newton per coulombs, which is equivalent to 1.6 in 10 power 7 newton per coulombs. The direction of the electric field points to left, but same direction as E2. So this is the resultant electric field of the at the charge Q3. Third problem, uniform line charge having the line charge density rho L is equal to 25 nanocoulombs per meter, which lies in the line x is equal to minus 3 meters and y is equal to 4 meters in the free space. Find the electric field intensity at a point 2, 3, 15 meters. So first write what is the suitable formula to find the electric field intensity due to infinite line charge distribution. So electric field intensity due to infinite line charge distribution you derived already as E is equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into R into ARR AY volts per meter. What is the direction of the unit vector? Vector R is equal to phi AX minus AY. And next, what is, so how we are getting phi AX? So this is very simple. So 2 minus of minus 3 and this 3 minus 4, nothing but 5 AX minus AY you are getting. And modulus of R is equal to root 26. So this is obtained by taking square root of 5 square plus 1 square, nothing but root 26. Then what is the direction of the unit vector? Direction unit vector is equal to vector R divided by modulus of the vector R. It becomes phi AX minus AY divided by root 26. So you will get what is that, 86.42 AX minus 17.284 AY. This is your this is the final electric field intensity after substituting rho L value and this AR value and this epsilon naught value and R value. Rho L is equal to 25 nanocoulombs and epsilon naught is nothing but 1/36 × 10⁻⁹ and this R value is equal to root of 26 and AY is nothing but 5 AX minus AY divided by root 26. And finally, electric field intensity due to infinite line charge distribution is obtained as 86.42 AX minus 17.284 AY. So these are the VTU questions. So these are the important questions, important problems for the examination point of view. We have number of problems on the point charge distribution and line charge distribution and surface charge distribution. Only two I extracted from the VTU question paper. One is find the electric field intensity at the origin due to a point charge of 6.44 nanocoulombs located at 4, 2, −3 meters in the Cartesian coordinate system. So this is very simple problem. So one is the origin point, another is the point at which you are going to find the electric field. So you are required to find electric field intensity at the origin. So due to the charge of 6.44 nanocoulomb located 4, 2, −3 and use the formula of E is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square unit vector AR and substitute the values and you will get the electric field intensity at the origin. Similarly, next problem, point charges of 15 nanocoulombs each are located A of 1, 0, 0, B of minus 1, 0, 0, C of 0, 1, 0 and D of 0, −1, 0 meter. Find the total force on the charge at A. Also find electric field intensity at A. First find the force at the charge A due to the charge at B, due to the charge at C, due to the charge at C, due to the charge at D. Later find electric field intensity at the point A, means total force divided by the charges will get the electric field intensity. These two are very simple. Please refer any textbooks and solve out these problems. Thank you for watching this video.